Good morning, everyone. I just enjoy banging this gong because it's so nice. I just want to gong more, that's all. Say again, get attached to it, that's right. Okay, so let's start the day as usual by doing some meditation together. So please sit comfortably, get yourself ready, and we'll just get started here. All right, so again, just the preliminaries, the basics of meditation. Every meditation should have a kind of regular pattern where you go through a similar kind of process. And the idea is to let go, basically. The idea is to find comfort and ease. The more you let go, the more easeful you will feel. These are two sides of the same coin. If you don't feel at ease, it's a sign you haven't really let go. So it's kind of an easy way to know whether you are heading in the right direction or not, whether you're feeling at ease and enjoying yourself. So always start off by feeling the body. so much of the tensions and the problems in life can be felt in the physical body. And when the body is relaxed, it is a sign the mind is also relaxed. It's an easy way of having some idea what is going on. So again, just be kind to yourself, have a sense of self-compassion, a sense that you deserve to relax and to be happy, and just focus on those points and just release that tension that you may have until you are really enjoying just sitting here and there is no complaints of any kind. The trick of meditation practice is to be able to combine relaxation and mindfulness. Sometimes if we are mindful, we are tense because we're trying too hard. And if we are relaxed, we lose the mindfulness and go into fantasies and thoughts. So usually it's one way or the other. What we're trying here is to combine the ideas of mindfulness and relaxation. Which may seem hard at the beginning, but gradually, as you learn how to guide the mind in the right direction, it tends to fall into place. And sometimes we just need some approximations, some similes for how to do this. And one way of thinking about meditation practice is to think a bit like watching a sunset. If you watch a sunset, you tend to be relaxed, you tend to be where you are, and you don't try too hard. You're just aware of the sunset. And one reason why it works so well is because you are enjoying the beauty of the spectacle. And this gives an idea of meditation. If you enjoy what you're doing, that is when you can relax and be mindful at the same time. So find the beauty of meditation. Find the aspects that are delightful and worthy of focusing on. The delight, the peace, the calm, the joy, whatever is there. And as you delight in that, then the meditation tends to come together. And as you go along, very often you will find that you need some more inspiration in the practice, something to lift up the mind a little bit, to give rise to a bit of brightness and joy. And there's so many ways of doing this, but one of the beautiful ways is to reflect how fortunate you are to be part of these Buddhist teachings, to have access to the word of the Buddha, to be a disciple of the greatest spiritual genius in human history. The Buddha is this extraordinary character, someone who gives the greatest gift to humanity, and has given that gift to us, to each one of you. What an immensely good fortune it is to be able to receive that gift and then to practice in accordance with it. It's just an extraordinary thing that there are beings like the Buddha who understand the human condition and who are able to pass on that vital information that creates happiness in the world and moves us away from suffering. Just the fact that you are a disciple, a student of the Buddha, should be able to give rise to great joy and happiness. Okay, so again, just take a few moments just to review your meditation today. Again, focusing on the causes and conditions that make the meditation work. Okay, let's take a short break.